In this video, we are going to look at 5 NHL game situations to analyze what the goalie did right or what they did wrong. If you stay until the end, I will tell you the easiest way to get better at goaltending. It costs 0 money and it can be done anywhere. Let's jump into clip number 1. Clip number 1 is a Joey Decord breakaway save. Decord had tons of depth, but he was moving back quick enough to be ready to play a deke. The shooter gave away early that he was going to shoot and behind the hash marks, which is too far away in my opinion. That leg lift that he does here signals a shot. Now if he was closer to the net, he could have lifted the leg and still deked, but because he was so far away, it was obvious that he wasn't going to skate close enough to the net for a deke on just one leg. Therefore, his only option was to shoot, and Decord recognized that, probably not consciously thinking about it, but I'm sure he just felt it instinctively. The open stick angle by the shooter also makes it obvious that he's going blocker side. Again, not something that a goalie thinks about as it happens, they just recognize it by instinct after facing many thousands of shots. I also really like the way Decord is able to track this puck off the pad and swipe the rebound away. This is a sign of a very dialed in goalie and it's a great save. Clip number 2 is basically the opposite of clip 1, Joey Decord again, but this time he gets scored on and that's just because the shooter played this very well. He faked a shot, he got Decord to bite, and then he just went around him. This is a great goal, a tough play for a goalie to make, but let's look at how you could play this situation in an ideal way. First of all, I actually think he's too far out here. By the time the shot is faked, he's still outside of the crease. I think he could have been a skate length back and touching the top of the crease. Secondly, he needed to avoid the full butterfly in this situation. This is where I like the one knee lower option, so instead of butterflying, you'd lower one knee to cover some 5-hole area, but you're still able to skate and move backwards. You've probably seen Carey Price make this kind of save, and I really like it because once you drop down to a full butterfly on a breakaway, you're stuck. Before he butterflied, he also set his feet, which you don't really want to do on a breakaway because once your feet are set, you don't have that backward skating ability anymore. You'll see a lot of goalies make breakaway shot saves while they're still moving back. This is better because it allows you to still be ready for a deke, but also you're set and ready to face the shot. The reality is that this is a good move. I have been beat this way many times before. It happens to all goalies and it's hard to avoid sometimes. The previously mentioned tips can help, but a good fake and deke can really freeze you. So we have to give credit where credit is due. Clip number 3 is a really bad goal in my opinion. Antti Raanta gets into an RVH where he doesn't need to and he gets beat by a cross ice pass. I love the RVH, which you will see in the next clip, but when it's used in the wrong situation, it can be pretty bad. In this play, Raanta goes down into an RVH for a cross ice pass that's closer to the hash marks than the crease. I would understand going down if the pass was close to the net, but it's far away and he should have stayed on his feet. There's a chance he didn't see the pass clearly and he thought it was a shot on net, which would be understandable if he went to the RVH because of that. But a cross ice pass like this one, he should have stayed on his feet. It would have given him much better control, he wouldn't have been frozen, and he could have gotten across to make the save. This is where patience and confidence is so important. I always talk about slowing the game down and using your eyes instead of reacting with your body. Raanta could have stayed on his feet, stayed patient, tracked the puck with his eyes, and instead of dropping down into an RVH or a butterfly, he could have stayed on his feet and had more power and stability to get across the ice and make the save. Instead, like Decord in the previous clip, he was down in a full butterfly slash RVH and it took him too long to recover and get over for the pass. I do like the flexibility and the desperation save he tries to make at the end, but it just wasn't enough. Clip number 4 shows the RVH done really well. The puck is in close to the net. He covers the bottom part for tap-ins in front of the net and you can't stand up in this situation because your 5-hole and corners of the net are open. So it's important to stay down and cover the bottom part of the net and project that coverage out so that the puck has to get over you, which it's not likely going to do. I also like how he pushes out far when the puck is in the slot and he makes the save. So he's not just staying on his line in the RVH position, he pushes out to get some depth and cut down the angle and he makes the save. The RVH is a great tool and it's perfect for this scenario. When you have tight plays behind the net, no player that has the space or the full control of the puck to really raise it, the RVH is a good tool to use in this situation because it allows you to cover the bottom portion of the net and it stops the kind of tap-ins and bang-in plays that can happen in this kind of situation. Clip number 5, Raanta again. Sorry, he's a good goalie, but it was a rough night. And this just goes to show you that no matter what you do, sometimes you have no chance. A one-timer from Steve Stamkos at the face-off dot, you don't have time to react to that. You just try to get big and hope that the puck hits you. Of course, this shot was in a perfect spot over the shoulder. The only thing Raanta could have done to make the save, in my opinion, was get some more depth. It looks like the puck hit his shoulder and kept going into the net. And if he was a little bit further out, it would have hit his shoulder and been a save instead of just catching a piece of his shoulder on the way into the net. This is, of course, easier said than done. Getting depth in this situation is hard because you can see that he tried, but there just wasn't enough time. And this clip's to show you that as goalies, sometimes we have no chance no matter what we do. So sometimes you just can't feel bad. Now, finally, the method to get better at goaltending that I talked about at the beginning of this video, and that is to do just what I did here. Analyze NHL clips to get better at understanding the game. I myself learned a lot just from making this video, so imagine if you did this every day, you would become a much smarter goalie. If I was a goalie who wanted to get better, I would try to watch highlights of games every day if possible. Study them and ask yourself, why did the goalie make the save, or why did they not make the save? What did they do that helped them, and what did they do that hurt them? If you do this every day or every week, that knowledge will compound and you'll understand the game better than anyone.